And so today we're going to learn about how to change or how to replace the handlebar tape on your bicycle. Okay, first of all, let's take a look at the things you're going to need, the supplies you're going to need before changing your handlebar tape, okay? First of all, you're going to need some kind of a blade or knife, especially for removing the old tape, a scissors to cut your tape. This will be a finishing, touching tape. I'll show you what these are used for later around your grips. Some electrical tape. If your bike uses end plugs, you're going to need these. Mine do not require end plugs because I have shifters there. And then, of course, your new tape for the right side and your new tape for the left side, which are interchangeable. Okay? So these are your basic supplies you will need for this job. Okay? As you can see here, I already removed my old handlebar tape and I have put my hood rubber up, out of the way. I still have my old electrical tape remaining from my last job 4,000 kilometers ago. So that's still intact and nice, so I won't need to touch that at all. Also down here, my electrical tape is still there. It's still fine and wonderful. No need for any change in that. But the reason for this tape, obviously, is to hold down your cables, so that it's out of the way when you are applying your new tape. Also take note that you have to decide where you want to stop your new job and then have your tape go up to the place where you're gonna stop. So I have mine right here. That will be my stopping point for the new tape. And then this will be my stopping point for the new tape on this side so that it's equal. Yeah, okay. Once again, put your hoods up out of the way by simply just folding them back. I want to show you a little, not all hoods have this, but there might be a little bit of a indentation. This will have to match this hole later. See this indentation? That will match this notch later. Okay, so we won't want to cover this notch with any type of tape on the new job. Leave this uncovered or vulnerable, open, okay? One of the first things you want to do before you get started is know the strength of your tape, Because you're going to be pulling it with a little bit of weights, a little bit of a tension. So you need to know how strong it is for stretching so that you don't snap it or tear it when you're applying it. So just take your tape and put a little tug on it and kind of pull on it. Mine is like almost untearable, so I can put a lot of pressure on mine when I'm wrapping it, no problem for me. Another thing to take note of is this is a perfect time to change your shifter cable casings or your brake cable casings, if that's a job you think you need to be doing also. Once your handlebar tape is off, this is a perfect time to change your casings if necessary, if it's that time of the year for general maintenance, Do it now while you have your tape off, because it's a big waste if you have to change your cables and remove all of your tape later. My cables are fine still, so I have no need to do any of that maintenance today. Of course, the third thing, which I mentioned earlier, is to mark your end points with the electrical tape so that you know where to stop later. pull back your hoods, which I mentioned earlier. Get your finishing tape ready, which I have here. I have two types that I can use. This one has a little bit of a nice surface on it, and this one looks almost like basic electrical tape. So I'll decide which one I'm going to use later. This is actually longer, but I actually like the square cut better. When we start this job, we're going to start from the bottom going up. Do not start from the top going down. So always start from the bottom going up. Do one side first, finish it, and then do the other side second, and then finish it. Bottom up. Another thing we need to take note of is the wrapping direction of the tape based on the hand load. So on the bottom here, on the bottom drop, normally your hands will go this way, right? And on this side, your hand is going to be slide to this side. So naturally, when we wrap our tape, we're going to wrap it in the direction in which the tape would most likely tighten as we slip with our hand. So our tape is going to go this way. It's going to go counterclockwise so that our natural momentum of our hand will help the tape to stay on rather than take the tape off. So on this side, we're going to go around clockwise, but this way we're going to go around counterclockwise. When we get to the top, naturally the hand will go downward, you know, especially when you're going up a hill, you're going to be, going like this. So we're going to want to wrap the tape in the direction that will most likely tighten the tape rather than loosen the tape. So on this side, it's going to go this direction, right? And on this side, it's going to go this direction so that we're tightening it rather than loosening it. So to remember this, just go right side towards out, left side towards out. Right out, left out. Another point I want to make is I love the tape that has the adhesive on it. And so we will undo this adhesive just enough as we progress along the bar. But the goal of your adhesive is to touch the actual metal, to touch the bar. So it's not adhesive on top of tape, but adhesive on top of the bar. Now there are some times where you can't help that, and putting the adhesive on top of the tape. Like in my last wrapping job, I know that happens sometimes, but if it's possible, try to have the sticky part here actually touching the metal part. Yeah. Okay. I'll show you that later when we do it. Oh, another little thing to consider is if you do not like the position of your grips, if you don't, your brakes, if you don't like the position, if you want it to be lower or higher, this is the time to make that adjustment. Yeah. Well, I think that's it. We're going to go ahead and get started and start wrapping. I think we're going to do our left side first, okay? Let's begin. Okay, when you start with your first one, try to put your edge somewhere, hide it towards the bottom so it's out of sight. Like maybe there would be a good spot because I have this little hump here, so I'm gonna put it right there. And don't peel all of your tape off. Just peel enough tape off so you have something to work with. But put it right on the edge there, nice and sticky. And I'm applying tension at the same time. Yeah, nice and tight. Beautiful. Okay, I'm gonna stop right here for a moment. Just take a quick little break. I'm gonna cut off my okay, this part here is designed to go in this spot. Can you see it? Right here. So it's mostly for cosmetic purposes, this piece, to be put right here. See that? Okay, here's our little part here. I'll just remove the adhesive backing. Yeah, see? And then we're gonna put it right here, just like that. And then we'll wrap it around this side. Just like that. Press that in. I'm a couple millimeters off, but it doesn't matter because when we drop our hood, when we pull down this hood, it'll cover it, okay? All right. Pretty easy, that part. Okay, the next part is a little bit tricky because we want to make sure that our wrap, when it's up here, it's going this direction. So that when we are going up a hill or riding, we are pulling the wrap. So what I usually do is I make sure this is not sticky. I just do a little practice fake job to make sure I am going the right way. So it looks like this is what I will do, just like this, okay? That's how I will do it. Just like that. Okay, so a little practice there. There's other trickier moves that some people do, figure eight, where they go around and around, but mostly on the old bikes, you could do that because the tape was so thin, like vinyl thin tape. You could go around and around this area no problem. But now with the tape being cushiony, too much times around this area makes it so bulky. So I think I'm ready. I'm just going to remove my backing a little bit here. Let me get my scissors. You really don't want to make too many mistakes because that adhesive, you don't want to, you know, have to unstick it again. So I'm going to get pretty close there. Okay, I'm pretty satisfied with that. Make sure, see if I remember. Okay, I'm pulling it a pretty. Yeah, that's okay. There. That's pretty nice. I'm pretty satisfied with that job. Looks like I might even have some leftover tape, which is pretty good. I'm pulling it a little tighter than normal here because this is where it really gets a workout. My hands are in this place the most. Let me cut that white tape off. It bothers me. Yeah, this will be really nice. Okay. Boy, they really designed this tape almost perfectly to the end. I'll show you a little trick at the end here. Sometimes I get a little bit nervous at the end because you don't want to run out of tape. The goal, if possible, is to finish with your edge on the bottom. I usually tape it down anyhow, so it's not the end of the world. Matter of fact, I think I'm not gonna stop at the bottom, but I'm gonna go ahead and bring it all the way up. Nope, changed my mind. I'm gonna snip it off right down here. I'll show you another little trick. Let me shorten this a little bit right here. You can also put a little bit of an angle on here, like so. See that? So that it will. Now I want to put that finishing tape right on there. Okay, finishing tape. Yeah, remember this piece here? Just remove the backing, of course. Beautiful. Yeah. And we're going to start it right where we ended with our handlebar tape so that we can grab it just a little bit there. Make it flush right there. Pull it tight and make yourself a nice looking edge. It's nice if you can finish this on the bottom, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to. I'm not going to do it this time. I'll let it finish right there. I'm not so mega perfect on looks, you know? So, for just extra support, I will sometimes just put electrical tape here and go around this a few times just to make it double strong. And nobody will know the difference except me. We can put our hood down now. Looks like I'm about ready to replace my hoods very soon. I can tell they're getting weary. Well, that's it. One side is complete. So now we'll do side two, and I think we'll be finished. For side two, I think I'm gonna just do most of it, because you've seen already the principles on how to do each side, how to do a completed side. So let me just quick whip this one out, and then we'll bring it to the end, okay? Once again, start at the bottom. Going outward, put this towards the bottom, stick it towards the bottom, pulling it tight. Okay, don't forget, we want the wrap to be able to come up this way, so that it's pulling tighter with our... So to do that, I gotta go around here and bring it across. It's okay under there. Okay, good. Good, beautiful. All right. Nice and tight. There we go. Perfect. Put that adhesive right on the bar. Keep it tight. Boy, it's nice when it's tight. It's nice when it's good quality tape that doesn't tear really easy. Tight, tight, tight. Oh, that's really nice. That's strong. I can really pull on that. That's great. It's a lot better than my last tape. I'll say it, but I got my last tape at Decathlon sports store. Although it was soft tape and absorbent tape, it was definitely not as strong as this one. Okay, getting closer to the end here. Yeah, okay, I got a little extra. Perfect. Perfect. Yeah, perfect. Let's see here. Yeah. That's a lot better than my other side. Oh, yeah. All right. Now this stuff here. Finishing tape. Again, we put it on the edge of our handlebar wrap. Okay, put down our little hood here.